Hey Jaguars, I'm Zach Rojas.
And I'm Mark Wiener. And this edition of The Recap starts... now. Hey, you know the two things I love the most?
Sleeping and eating?
Yes, but even more than that, seniors and basketball.
Oh, I would never guess that. But speaking of seniors and basketball, did you check out Senior Night at Coral Glades?
I did. It was a great way to see our Jaguar seniors play one last time. Watch this.
The basketball team played their final game on January 31st against South Broward High School. The game was one last goodbye to the five seniors on the team.
Seniors in any basketball, football, sports program are very important because they should represent exactly what your program should stand for. My particular group of seniors this year, out of five of them, three of them have been in the program for 4 years. A great group of guys in terms of basketball. They all bring something unique and tangible to the team. And I hope that throughout their time here at the program that they've learned something that they can take with them. Not with the game of basketball, but in terms of the game of life.
Now I'm going to miss basketball, but after basketball, I got a whole nother volleyball season coming up, so you know, it's going to be tough, but it'll be okay.
The Jaguars come out on top with a score of 49-45.
It may not have went exactly how they would want it to go, but I'm sure in the end, they're happy because the ultimate goal is to win.
Well, we played pretty well. I was happy that we came out with the win. I was upset that I couldn't play because I had an ankle injury, but overall, it was a good ending to the season.
Overall, the Jaguars had a great season, and the team will certainly miss their seniors. From WJAG, I'm Trey Shane.
I'm not feeling very well.
What's wrong?
I'm heartbroken.
I can give a piece of my heart.
Zach, stop taking titles of drama shows and making them cheesy lines, okay?
I'll try.
The Drama Club's latest production, A Piece of My Heart, is a Vietnam War drama with females playing the lead roles. This is the second major production of the school year.
Working on A Piece of My Heart was really an extraordinary experience. First of all, it's a drama, and it's only the second drama we've done here at Coral Glades. And it's mostly an all-female drama, even though there's some really able assists by three soldiers. But the six girls really needed to create the feeling of an ensemble. And that's something that you have to work hard at. It requires not just being at rehearsal. It requires being generous with each other. It requires listening to each other. And also, the other thing we needed to work on in the show is that the Vietnam War is something that I remember because I grew up in the 60s. But it's really, old history for a lot of my students. We spent a lot of time going into the causes of the war, the impact of the war, why it divided the country, what people felt like when they were over there, why the type of war it was different from any war that had been fought before. Because it was really necessary for all of these actresses to understand what happened there.
With four out of the six girls being seniors, this marks the end of their major productions at Coral Glades.
It was a really long experience. We got our scripts in September. And this whole month we've been rehearsing every day, learning about the war and getting to know each other as like a crew. We've gotten really close. And hopefully it went really well. I hope the people liked it.
Because there's so many talented members and you're just jumping from line to line to line and there's so many sound cues, it's confusing, but it's actually very exciting. And it's sad because this is my last show at Coral Glades and I'm going to miss being on stage with them.
The cast of A Piece of My Heart put on four shows and would like to thank everyone for coming out and showing their support. Look out for their next performance, the Renaissance Festival, on February 17th. With WJAG, this is Brooke Savage.
Prom, grad bash, graduation, senior dues, candy sales.
What about them?
Well, they're all very expensive. I'm just calculating it. It's going to be about $9,867.05.
How'd you figure that out? That's insane.
Well, I'm really bad at math, but I still figured it out anyway. And senior year is expensive. Check out this story about it.
Senior year is the year that everyone looks forward to. The thing that many don't know is the cost of being a senior.
As senior class vice president, we did enforce senior dues this year. And what seniors dues did is lower the cost for all seniors for everything they plan to do senior year, because there's a lot of costs involved with everything they're doing. And it was $25. And what this went for is lowering the cost of grab bash and prom tickets. Grab bash tickets for seniors who paid dues is $135, and for seniors who didn't is $150. So you can see the discounts. And why we did this is because senior class is making money for prom and for all the events while you guys are discounting on every single event.
Senior is ridiculous. The price of grab bash, prom, and I didn't pay my senior dues, that's just more out of my pocket.
I pay my senior dues, which is really good because that means I get to save money on grad bash and prom, and that's really good because money's tight, so like every penny helps, and now I can go shopping and not have to worry about like insane like prices on everything.
Right now they haven't really hit me that much, because I've only paid, you know, the $25 fee, but I know like once prom hits, it's gonna get really bad. And I feel like all the seniors need to start really fundraising for the prom so we can get those tickets down.
Thanks to senior dues, almost 250 seniors have reduced costs for prom and grad bash tickets. With WJAG, I'm Bridget Knight.
Where can I get chips, sodas, Gatorades, water, popcorn, honey buns?
Oh, probably in the vending machine.
That's a good idea, but I heard the prices went up.
Sucks.
Yeah, a little bit.
Recently, the prices on certain concessions in the school's vending machines have been raised. The prices are not controlled by the school, but by the company that supplies the machines, Gillies.
Ever since the vending machine prices got raised, I haven't been able to buy any food since I can't use the, I don't have an account here at the school lunch program, so since the vending machine's prices got raised, it's really not hard for me to get a decent meal.
The reliability of the machines is also questionable. Every day, students are spending their money on the machines just to have their candy or drink become stuck within the machine or have their dollar taken without further action.
I mean, for the fact that someone's spending their money, they're bringing it to school, and then they lose it, only finding out that they're not even allowed to shake the machine or have any help to get what they paid for, just isn't right.
With WJAG, I'm David Creasy.
Hey, Zach, did you do anything exciting this weekend?
Oh, you know, the usual. I help people with autism, you know, that kind of
stuff.
Oh,
that's interesting. How did you do that?
Well, there was an autism walk at Sun Life Stadium.
Sounds fun.
This past Saturday, the Dan Marino Foundation sponsored its first ever Walk About Autism at the Sun Life Stadium in Miami. This was a time for friends and families to get together as they formed teams supporting an autism patient, and they were able to enjoy a day of fun, games, food, and even get autographs signed. The funds raised through this event go to integrated treatment programs providing outreach services, advancing scientific research, and transition programs to build independence. From our school, we had our very own Noah Karp representing Team Noah at the walkabout. Only halfway through the event and $400,000 has already been raised. With thousands in attendance, it should be no problem meeting the eventual goal of $500,000. With WJAG, I'm Jacob Schroll.
WJAG would like to congratulate our four senior athletes who signed their letters of intent last Wednesday on National Signing Day. Good luck, Jaguars.
Here's the new question mark.
I don't want to make you look any stupider, so actually, yes, I do.
Who gives the State of the Union address?
I don't know.
Okay. Marco Rubio.
I have no idea.
Sad?
I don't know.
Okay, what two teams are in the Super Bowl?
Black and yellow! And the Packers, but we don't really care about them.
I'm guessing the Jets, the Green Bay Packers, and the Patriots.
Who is the new Speaker of the House?
That guy.
That guy who?
That important guy?
John Boner.
Don't ask me boring questions, ask me fun questions.
Fine, who am I? Who am I?
Christian.
No.
I don't know, Jackie.
No, actually Jewish.
Wait, what?
What American president was originally an actor?
An actor?
An actor.
I don't know nothing about presidents. This is a fun recap, isn't it?
You don't know nothing?
About presidents, no. Okay.
You don't know anything about English either.
Mark Wiener.
What is the largest state in the country?
Alaska.
Texas.
The largest state is California.
Who invented the light bulb?
Oh my God, this is so embarrassing.
Other than basketball, what sport did Michael Jordan play professionally?
I feel like it's golf.
None.
Mm-hmm. Golf?
Mm-hmm. Which presidents were assassinated?
Mark Wiener.
I think that's a threat.
Were there four presidents assassinated?
Yes. I checked.
He checked.
He Googled it.
And he can't say Googled. Synonym, but he okay. checked.
What is the antonym of the word cinnamon? Let's try that question again. What is the antonym of the word cinnamon?
Cinnamon.
What is the antonym of the word synonym?
Still said it wrong, didn't I?
I'm actually just going to show you the question.
He knows it, but... What is the antonym of the word synonym?
I can't say the word synonym.
That would be... Synonym.
Synonym.
No.
Synonym.
Oh. Synonym.
Yes, you got it.
I got it. Well, that's all we have for this edition of The Recap.
Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. I see your death.